Hi, hello everyone. My name is Suraj and welcome to the episode 2 of Achievers Under 25. Let me give you guys a quick introduction of who I am and what I do. So apart from running India's fastest growing analytics driven virtual reality company Quark, I host this show called Achievers Under 25, and I try to put one episode every week, and I have a very special guest with me today. His name is Abhimanyu Puranik. Welcome, Abhimanyu.
Hi.
Yeah. So Abhimanyu just turned 18 and he is into top 50 Grandmasters in India. And I was just looking at the list of the Grandmasters, and I think you must be in a top 10 youngest Grandmasters, if I'm not wrong. I mean, less than 18, right? So yay, kudos to that. So Abhimanyu, so tell us about your story. Where are you from? Where did you do your schooling and all of that?
Actually, I was born in Mumbai, but when I was about 3 years old, I moved to Pune. And after that, when I was about 5 years old, I started learning chess. Like, my mother used to take tuitions, and one of her students, he taught me the general moves, how to play and all. And from that, I started challenging my parents, my grandfather and all. And my mother and father both of them thought as a very good extracurricular activity, so they enrolled me in a local academy, and from then my journey started.
Oh, nice. So how long did it take you to defeat all of your family members?
Actually, at first I was really frustrated because my father used to pull off the same trick and beat me again and again. But then once I got enrolled in the academy, he showed the how to avoid the mate. So after that, I improved my score and slowly I started beating them every time.
When was the last time he beat you?
I don't remember.
That's funny. Okay. So where did your schooling in Pune?
I did my schooling in Symbiosis school.
Okay.
And I'm hugely indebted to them. Because of them, they gave me concessions and they encouraged me so many times. Like since I was, I don't know, 6-7 years old, they always encouraged me, and many times I had to miss school a lot. Like,
so you bunked school a lot?
Not bunked exactly,
but
okay.
It was a permissioned bunk.
Yeah, okay. If you say it like that, but like many of the times I had like 15% attendance and all, and
they have been very supportive.
But yeah, they have been very supportive.
So you just finished your 12th grade, right?
Yeah.
So you did from commerce.
Yeah.
So how was jungling around between 11th, 12th and chess practice?
Actually, I think that study, academics and chess go hand in hand. Like, because of chess, I am able to memorize things and very easily. Like, I can also concentrate for longer. So, because of chess, I can easily complete my exam portion within a very short period of time.
Okay.
And also because of academics, I get a break from chess, because if I just keep playing tournaments, sometimes the monotony comes.
You
I
tend
have to break
get
that
monotonous,
yeah,
right?
Like to defocus, I have to, like, academics helps sometimes. Okay.
Nice. So do you play any other sport to sort of rejuvenate yourself or sort of feel fresh outdoors?
Yeah, recently, like, I have started also to look towards my physical fitness, and play badminton, football, cricket with my local group, my
nice.
Friends or chess friends, many people. So I've tried to play many sports. So
nice.
Okay,
nice. So, but you lose there even though you win chess all the time.
No, I win there also. Okay.
No, okay. Nice. So, what was the first milestone in your journey? So, you started playing chess at the age of 5. So, what was the first milestone?
Okay, when I was about 7 years old, my parents, actually I used to play in district tournaments, state tournaments.
That is in Pune district?
Yeah, like Pune district, state tournaments. I excelled there. But when I was 7 years old, my mother and father took a huge decision of sending me to Greece for playing a world school chess championship.
Wow.
In the under 7 category. And it was a very big decision for me, them, because like I was 7 years old, so I could not take such decisions. And they did not know what my real strength was, but they thought that because of my coaches told them that he can go and excel on an international stage. So one of the coaches from Mumbai, Mr. Raghunandan Gokhale sir, he's even sent a letter to my principal for telling them that he's participating. And I played very well there. I scored 9 out of 9 there.
Wow.
I won all the games, and from then I started taking chess more and more seriously.
Wow, wow. So, how was the journey from there to the Grandmaster title? I mean, you just turned Grandmaster last year, right? So, how was it? Was it difficult, or how was it? How many competitions were there in between? Which ones you lost, you thought you would have been Grandmaster before, or all of that?
Actually, it's a very big journey, because like, Grandmaster is like a very big title, and you have to have like a lot of patience, because sometimes I was stagnant, sometimes I was playing very well, but I never gave up, I never stopped. Like, I never thought that I should study only academics or even in 10th standard. Like, I never took a break before, like from June and all. I kept playing till January, and then I started focusing on my studies. And like, I just wanted to play more and more chess.
Okay. Okay, interesting. So, how do you prepare for chess? So, as a layman, like, you have this perception that you always have to keep playing. So, how long do you play every day, and how do you play? Like, what are the stages in which you play and prepare for the chess?
Okay, playing is just, I think, one part of preparation. There are a lot of things like, there are three phases in chess, like opening, which is the opening 15-20 moves, then middle game, when queens are on the board, and after end game means when queens are off the board. So like, I have to prepare separately for each and every part. So like, many times there are so many books in chess, there is a lot of chess literature available, and I just try to go through all those books. Like, I have a big library at my home.
Nice.
So that is like, you have to just keep on preparing. It's like knowledge only, it's discipline. You have to just keep on adding the knowledge.
Right.
And maybe that knowledge will not come to use immediately.
Correct.
But like, it will help you at some point.
Correct. So how long do you play every day, you said?
Okay, I try to prepare 5-6 hours a day.
Wow, 5-6 hours a day. That's amazing. So I want to ask you, so in chess, what happens is like, chess or overall in life, I mean, you know, because of your commitments towards your game or the preparation, you lose out on your friend's time and all of that. So how do you handle that part? How do you handle the balance?
Actually, I spend a lot of time with my friends, even though I'm playing. Whenever I'm here, I try to balance everything. I try to add every aspect of life. Although it's not always easy, but my parents always made sure that I had good social like circle, and I always like whenever I could I went to school because I didn't take any undue advantage and also
school is the best place to socialize.
Yeah, and I also have so many good chess friends from India, from abroad also, so it's like a whole new world actually.
Nice. So I'm not sure, because you're so young, whether you've had pressures in life. I'm sure everyone has their own part of it. But have you had those pressure moments, and how did you handle them? If you can summarize one or two, during the game, off the game, anyone.
Pressure moments is sometimes like you will have a string of bad performances, and like it becomes frustrating after a certain point. But okay, like my parents and my coach, Mr. Jayan Gokhale sir, they always like told me that don't need to worry, you have many more games to play. And such things, like I remember one time I was playing in 2014 in Bhubaneswar, and there I played very badly, but like I didn't somehow feel any pressure. Like after a certain point, actually I started enjoying the tournament, because I thought I had nothing to lose now, like.
Right.
So, and immediately after that I made my first title, but this is largely due to my parents. They themselves have a very positive attitude, and they like make sure that I do have a positive approach while playing. Like many sports persons, they will get upset easily, and it is good to get upset, but not during the tournament. I think
right.
If you want, you should not be down during the tournament. If it's okay, if you after the tournament, you should of course analyze your games and make and see what went wrong. But like, I never had that much pressure, but of course there were many pressure situations later also. Like last year was very important for me. I made my Grandmaster title and like I had to...
Did you have a big party after that?
Yeah, okay, I had.
That's nice. So what has been the longest duration game of yours and how long did it last and who was the opponent and can you share that experience with us?
Actually, I don't remember, but many times in chess the game will last for something like 4-5 hours.
4 to 5 hours.
I don't remember the longest game. I think it was about 6.5-7 hours in Isle of Man. I played in UK.
Who was your competitor?
It was Benjamin Bok from Netherlands, and that game it lasted for a very long time.
Who won it? What?
It was a draw.
Okay. So you are like just 18 and like you have worked your way till here since you were 7, 6, you know. And you are the classic example of telling someone that the advantage of starting something is like being young, right? So what do you tell youngsters? So whoever watching it here, whoever knows you, not knows you, doesn't know you, what's your advice for them? What is your advice for youngsters to start something, whatever they want to do in their life or achieve in their life?
I think it's like youngsters, maybe they have some passions, but it's more important to advise to parents sometimes, because parents, like many times they will try to impose their ideas, it's good, but like what parents should think is that let the child know what he has to do.
Let the child groom, let the child make his own mistakes,
yeah,
right? And then explore.
Let the child
the world.
Learn and then he'll learn from his own mistakes. But many times the parent will be like, no, do this, do that,
right.
Don't do this. So, okay, I think that if your child has a passion for something, it may not be like, it may be chess, it may be it may be music,
correct.
I don't know.
Correct.
So just let the child have his free hand. In today's world, it's necessary for everyone to have hobbies also.
Right.
So like,
right.
I think that parents should just let their child groom, basically. And for youngsters, I would like to say that just keep on working and have good patience, because many times you'll pursue something and you'll have some aim, but like
right.
That aim seems too tough. So you will just give up. So don't give up and just be patient and work hard always.
Yes, so advice to youngsters is that be consistent, have patience and keep working hard. So next is, so who's out of those mom and dad, who usually travels with you abroad whenever you go for competitions and like how she or he supports you during that?
I am going to competitions alone or with my chess friends for many years now. Like, but till I was something like 13, 14, my mother used to accompany me. But it's better for me. She thought that it was better for me to go alone, because it's a very good learning curve. Because many times we'll stay in an apartment and
right.
Like there will be 3-4 people. So somebody has to cook also.
Right.
So we would generally divide tasks. One
can
guy
you
will
cook?
Yeah, I can cook.
What all you can cook?
Okay, like khichdi, maggi, some, I don't know, basic sabzi and all.
Nice,
I can cook.
Nice. I don't know if any of the other 18-year-old kids can cook even that much. Yeah.
Okay. So like, and somebody has to peel the potatoes, somebody has to go to the supermarket and bring the...
What was the best experience abroad? Like any of the countries which you went to and that was the best tournament, like in terms of the whole experience? Forget the winning or losing.
No, I think I went to Spain in 2015. It was a very good experience. Because like every day we had to travel something like 2 hours.
Wow.
1 hour while going and 1 hour by coming back by metro. And but still it was very fun, because once what happened on metro while going to the venue, we were going by a fast train, so it did not stop at the point where our tournament. So we were late by something like 20 minutes and we just reached in time. So we learnt a lot of new things, and the place is also very good, I mean, for even tourists. So we also had a lot of fun. We went to many different places there. So overall, I think Spain is, even in terms of the result, it was very good for me. So I like that tournament.
So it was overall a fantastic trip. Okay. So what are your goals? Like what do you want to do yourself? Do in your life like 10 years, 20 years later? And so yeah, what are your plans for future?
I think I have a lot of short-term goals, Like my first goal is to become 2600. I need to have 2600 rating in chess. That is my immediate.
Goal. For the audience who's viewing it, for becoming Grandmaster, you need a score of more than 2500. So Abhimanyu has already crossed that, and now his next target is 2600. Yeah.
So that is my goal, and I try to have some short-term goals always. That helps me, because having a long-term goal always doesn't help, I think.
Right. And maybe you're too young to think so much long-term, right? Like, you can just complete the short-terms and enjoy the fun which comes around.
Yeah, I try to have fun whatever I do, like, while playing. Everything I try, even practice, it's fun for me. I try to make sure that everything is fun for me.
Okay. So, in terms of the sports, or, you know, your experiences in India and abroad, what do you think we can do better in India in terms of chess, because you've been there a lot? What are the differences you saw in India and abroad, chess infrastructure or chess support as such?
I think in India chess is doing really well. Like, from like 10 years before, I remember like 10-15 years before, there was something like just 16-17 grandmasters in India. And recently, the amount of grandmaster, even talented players, has increased a lot.
Right.
And I think in this sense, India is doing really well than other countries. Like, I think we are number 4 in world right now.
Okay, so who are the first three?
I think it is Anand sir, Hari Krishna sir, Vidit Gujarati, and I don't know, it's always like goes up and down, and but I think in terms of chess, I think India is going to be it is already a very big chess superpower.
Wow, that's fantastic to hear. I hope we can achieve in all that in all the sports, right? So yeah, so I think that's it for today. So we are wrapping it up for today, and stay tuned for more and more. If you like the show, if you like the concept, recommend me the people who you know who have achieved something massive and, you know, amazing and are less than 25 in age. And you can comment their names in the comment section, and I'll definitely follow them up for the next shows. Keep watching, and if you like the show and like the concept, share and subscribe for it. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.